What is going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, taking a look at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're going to be doing a quick trading update. What did I do today in terms of my trades? What stocks am I currently holding? And we're also going to be talking about this whole tariff situation with Trump, what he tweeted out on Sunday. And we're going to talk about if this is going to affect the stock market in a negative way in today's video, as well as just taking a brief look at some other stocks and ETFs that I'm personally watching and looking to trade here over the next couple of weeks. So before we do get into the topic of today's video, for everybody out there that finds value in these videos, you enjoy the stock breakdowns, the stock news updates here on my channel, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. It really supports me and supports the channel in general. And if you do enjoy the content throughout this video and you want to see more from me, consider subscribing to the channel. It would mean a lot to me. And thank you all out there for watching and keeping up with the content. Again, it means a lot to me. So without further ado, guys, let's talk about this whole situation, what happened with the stock market, and really the crazy recovery that we did end up seeing today. So I have the tweet pulled up here on my phone. Pretty much the gist of it, guys, is President Trump threatened to raise tariffs on about $200 billion in Chinese-made goods from 10% rather to 25%. He also threatened to extend the tariffs to include another $325 billion in Chinese imports. So for those of you guys that don't know, you know, the U.S. and China, they've been in a trade war over the past couple of months, right? It's been a while now that these two mega countries, these mega economies, have been in a trade war, right? And this is something that has caused a bunch of uncertainty in the market. A bunch of people have been scared, right? A lot of people think, you know, this has caused the selling off that we saw a couple of months ago. Really, in my opinion, that was a key factor in this selling off that we did see. And over the past couple of weeks and months, we've honestly, from the media, right, from a couple of tweets from other outside sources, we've been getting information that Trump and China, they've been getting closer and closer to coming to a trade war agreement, right? And in my opinion, this is why the stock market has rebounded so heavily, so nicely in the year of 2019, right? I believe the market in general has priced in a trade deal occurring. And the fact that we got this news from Trump yesterday, this tweet from Trump, really telling us, the investors out there, the traders out there, that they really aren't that close to a trade deal, right? This really spooked the entire market, which sent it in shambles, right? It sent it in shambles. The market sold off very aggressively this morning. And again, in my opinion, you know, the market has priced in a trade war potentially occurring very soon. And this news coming out told us, the market in general, that, okay, maybe there isn't a trade war deal coming soon. Maybe they aren't even close to it. Maybe they've just been leading us on. And this is what a bunch of people out there in our community, the stock market community in general, believe as well. And again, this sent the market down like crazy. So now that we got the gist of the scenario that's been going on over the past couple of months and what happened yesterday, let's talk about what happened in the markets today, right? We closed at about -$13 today, -0.45% on the SPX, which is absolutely unbelievable, because if we look on the 1 day, 1 minute, we gapped down all the way to 28.98, pretty much erasing all of the gains that we saw last week and the past couple of weeks, actually. If we go on the 20 day, 1 hour chart, You know, these were gains stemming back from the middle of April. We were right around 2,900. We popped up to 2,954. We saw the Fed chair speak on Wednesday last week. The stock market went down to 2,900, or the SPX rather went down to 2,900. We popped back up on Friday on that very strong day, and we pretty much, again, erased those gains back down to about 2,900 today, where we ended up closing at about 2,930. So that's what the SPX is looking like right now at the close. Hopping over here to the Dow Jones, we're down about 66 points, down about 0.25%, which again is unbelievable because at one point today, guys, the futures yesterday especially, they were down 500 points. So we were down to 26,033 today at the lowest at about 9:30. And from there, we were able to shoot up all the way nearly 430 points towards the close of the market, where we ended up closing at about $26,438. And we were talking about this in the group chat this morning. I kind of, to myself, and I said this in the group chat, you know, the fact that we were down nearly 500 points in the Dow, we were down like 50 points in the SPX, we were down about 2% in general pre-market hours, you know, I didn't really see the market's going down further from that, which led me to believe that we were going to recover throughout the day, right? I wasn't, you know, 100% set on us recovering, but I had a feeling that since, again, we were down so heavily pre-market, I figured that, you know, the bad news is already priced in from the futures and pre-market, that the market would slowly recover, right? But of course, you know, there was a chance that I would be completely wrong and we were to sell off, but I just happened to be right in my thinking there. And we did exactly that, right? We ended up recovering very nicely. I didn't think, honestly, we were going to recover all the way up to where we did, but hey, it happened, which again is absolutely blowing my mind based off of this news and the uncertainty that this news is really causing in the market, which we're going to be talking about here in a couple of minutes. So the NQ, also known as the NASDAQ, ended up closing the day down about 0.8%, down $62.75. And if we go to the 1 day, 1 minute, or we are at the 1 day, 1 minute actually, we can see we were actually down to about 76.87 earlier on today near the open of the market. And at that point, we were down about 110-ish points below from where we are now. So the NQ was down nearly 200 points at the open of the market, which again is unbelievable. And we can see we recovered for the entire day there, which again, I can't reiterate it and say it enough, is unbelievable, right? So hopping back over here to the S&P 500, you know, we're noticing a tight resistance level at about 2950, right? We talked about how on Wednesday, last Wednesday, the Fed meeting, right, the stock market dropped from there to 2900. We popped back up to around 2945, got rejected again there with the gap down that we saw today. So needless to say, there is a very strong resistance level right around 2945 to 2955 in terms of the SPX, the S&P 500. And what we're noticing here on a technical basis is we were able to hold the 50 simple moving average as a support here after the big sell-off that we saw. So this is a good sign that the market is A, recovering, it's B, holding the uptrend, and C, it wants to continue this uptrend, right? So on the longer term chart here on the SPX, very good sign that we're seeing there. But one thing I want to point out to you guys here is if we're going into a smaller time frame chart, this one being the 20-day, 1 hour, what are we noticing here? Towards the end of the market, we're noticing a potential lower high forming on the SPX. Remember, we talked about how at 29.55, this was our high. We dropped after the Fed meeting. We popped back up, 29.46. This was a lower high from the previous. We dropped on today's news, or yesterday's news rather, and now we popped back up. And we're seeing a resistance at the 50 simple moving average resistance. And we're slowly starting to see some red candlesticks forming here and after hours as well. So tomorrow, are we going to sell off even further? Is this news going to span the entire week, which I think is possible, right? This is something to keep an eye on. Keep an eye. Are we going to sell off further here, or are we going to break this resistance? Maybe have a green day, miraculously have a green day tomorrow, recover, all stocks recover, we push up to a higher high, maybe break the all-time high. Watch these levels, guys. Very, very important. So back over here to the Dow Jones, we're noticing something very similar here on the 20-day, one-hour chart, right? Lower high, lower high, lower high, lower high, right? We're kind of seeing a descending pattern here in the Dow Jones over the past couple of days. And if we're hopping here to the 184-hour chart, we can see with the sell-off we saw, we sold off to about, what was it, like 26,000 flat, roughly, right? About $26,033, and from there, we obviously broke, or at this point, we obviously broke the 26,200 level of support, which is right here. We broke below it, and of course, we broke the $26,400 level of support as well. But from there, we were able to, with the recovery we saw today, we were able to break out of this resistance of 26,200, making it a support again. And now, towards the end of the market, we actually closed above 26,400, holding that level as a support again as well. So keep an eye tomorrow, guys. Are we going to hold this horizontal channel that we're in yet again between 26,400 and 26,800? Are we going to continue potentially this descending pattern that we are seeing here on the Dow on the 20-day, one-hour chart with this bad news that we got regarding the trade war? What do you guys think about that, actually? I'm going to ask you right now. Drop a comment down below. Let me know what you think about this whole situation. Is this going to be, you know, short-term news that will only affect the market today, and let's say we bounce back tomorrow? Or do you think this is going to be a long-lasting effect of, let's say, a week or 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks on the market, where we'll be selling off for gradually for a couple of maybe weeks here, a couple of days? Let me know down below in the comment section what you guys think about that. And just like the Dow and the SPX, the NASDAQ is in the same situation, right? We're pretty much still trading in this channel that we talked about in last week's videos, and it's really still intact, right? This channel of lower highs lower highs and lower lows, it's still intact, right? With the sell-off we saw today, we hit a lower low, we popped up, we're at a lower high right now, we're seeing some resistance towards the top of this channel and at a lower high position. So this is, in my eyes, a sign where we could potentially be selling off more in the NASDAQ tomorrow. And judging on the 184 hour, we're just simply at this point, you know, maintaining on top, or actually, yeah, we're well above the all-time highs from back in October in 2018. We've held those levels as a new support. We're popping up. And at this point, guys, if we break out of this channel, right, that would be a breakout bullish pattern on the NASDAQ. But if we get rejected and we start to push down and we break the support of the channel, that's 100% going to be a bearish move. And from there, we could expect some more selling in the NASDAQ. So that's the overall gist of what ended up happening today. One of the most crazy days that we've seen over the past couple of weeks, in my opinion. And I personally think that there is a possibility that this news, in terms of the trade war, the trade deal, this could span over a couple of more days, right? And this is why, kind of segmenting into the trading portion of this video, why I was extremely, extremely cautious today, right? There wasn't much movement, you know, in my portfolio. There was a bunch of bounce back plays, you know, on Apple, you know, Facebook, Amazon, Google, these large cap companies. They obviously sold off very heavily today with the market selling off. You know, they were day tradable as the market was going up. But to be completely honest, I didn't really play any of them, nor did I add more to my positions, because, again, going back to what I said, You know, this could end up selling the markets off for a couple of days, and I just don't want to take that risk quite yet. I kind of want to see what the market is going to be looking like tomorrow based on the pre-market futures, you know, large caps, you know, if Trump sends out any more tweets, right? This can very heavily, you know, fluctuate the market. I just need to see for my own, my own strategy, my own conservative approach here. I just need to see what the markets are looking like tomorrow before I make any more moves regarding my swing plays. But what I did do today, guys, was I traded crude oil and UWT. Crude oil is one that actually saw a crazy, crazy recovery today, right? We saw on the 1 day, 1 minute, this one recovered from about $60.47. This was in the late morning, I guess you can say early morning of the 6th of May, about 3:15 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We saw a push all the way up to nearly $63 on crude oil, and I pretty much traded it on this pullback that we saw here more towards the close of the market today. We saw a pullback from 62.73 down to about 62.22, and if we see UWT, let me just pull a double chart here so we can see how UWT was reacting towards this. And if we can get it here, UWT. So let's go to the 1 day, 1 minute. Let's go to the 1 day, 1 minute so we can see exactly what I'm talking about here. So at about what time was that? 1:47, UWT was at about $20.18. We pulled down to about 1976 as crude oil pulled down to about 62.28. And at this point, I started to see the recovery on crude oil from this pullback. The RSI pulled back as well. And we started to see a higher low forming and the continuation of the uptrend here on the 1 day, 1 minute. So I pretty much just hopped in on this one on a very quick day trade from about 1994 up to about the higher high point here at about $20.30. And that was quite a good day trade on my part, guys. And I'm glad that I was actually on the computer and watching the markets closely, because if I wasn't, quite honestly, I would have missed the move. And I don't know why it's not letting me show you the margin of profit. Let me just go and go here really quickly, and I'll show you guys on the single chart. But from 1994, roughly, when I ended up getting into crude oil, or UWT rather, up to about 2030, I was able to get about a 1.75 profit on a very quick day trade on UWT. And I'm very happy with this, again, because up until this point, I was being patient. I wasn't really adding money into my swings because I'm just nervous in terms of, how long this can affect the market, right? I know I mentioned it a couple of times in this video, but I want to keep saying it because I do think there is a possibility that this could affect the market for a couple of days here. So that's all I did in terms of my day trading today, guys. In terms of my swings, I'm in Google, right? I'm in Facebook, and I'm in Procter & Gamble. All of those, I'm still holding on to them right now. They're not doing too great, but they didn't do too poorly either today. They all pretty much recovered near to where I ended up buying them, especially Google and Facebook. Procter & Gamble, I'm still on the green on this one. We pretty much had a consolidation day today. Nothing too crazy on Procter & Gamble. I still feel comfortable holding on to this one. And that's pretty much it, honestly, for the trading update portion of today's video. So drop a comment down below. Let me know, what did you guys end up trading today? And again, your opinions on the market, I would love to know. So now let's talk about what ended up, not really what ended up happening, but what stocks ended up doing well today, what stocks ended up recovering, and what I'm watching for tomorrow and for the rest of this week. So pretty much, guys, a bunch of the stocks on my watch list were red today, right? I'm sure a lot of you can relate. And a bunch of them were able to recover very nicely, right? We saw AMD dip down to the $26 level today. It recovered pretty nicely towards the end of the market, right? We saw the dip down at $26.50. They recover back up. We saw Apple dipped to about 205, I believe, or 203. This one recovered very nicely. We saw Facebook dip down to about 189 pre-market hours. It popped up to 193.75. We saw TVIX today, guys. This one, I would have traded this one, to be honest, but the move was already, it was kind of impossible to trade this one unless you were in it from Friday, because it gapped up 20% all the way up to nearly $24 pre-market hours. And from there, it didn't really do anything because we saw the markets recovered very nicely. So what am I watching for the rest of this week? So I'm watching TVIX, probably is the number one that I'm watching just in case the markets continue to sell off. For those of you guys that don't know, TVIX is an ETF that trades based upon the S&P 500. It's going up whenever the S&P 500 is selling off. Hence why this one was up 20% today pre-market hours, because the markets in general, the S&P, were selling off. So S&P, or TVIX rather, is the number one that I'm watching for the rest of this week and tomorrow, guys. So Apple is another one that's very interesting right now. We gapped down. We ended up holding the 50 SMA as a support here, and we're at a pretty decent price that's offering a nice margin of profit here on Apple. So if the markets do recover, Apple slowly starts to trend up to the 210 range, this can be a pretty solid swing play, again, if the markets do recover. And this is why I have some plays on both sides of the spectrum, right? Apple is a play where I'd play it if the markets are recovering and doing well despite this news. And TVIX is on the other side of the spectrum, right? Let's say the markets continue to sell off. That's a play that I can use in my arsenal to make money when the markets are going down. So it's super important to have plays on both sides of the spectrum. So Apple, definitely one that's interesting right now. You know, what other ones here? Atvi's one that we talked about in my video yesterday. Atvi, again, is one of those that fell, ended up recovering very nicely today off the 180 SMA here on the 184-hour chart. It's looking like we're trending up towards the $48 resistance. We're breaking out of that slowly. If we do break it tomorrow or continue to pop above it and maintain it as a new support, just like I said in Sunday's video, the one that I uploaded yesterday, you know, this could be a nice gap fill play up to the next resistance, up to about $51.50. Watching that area very closely here. Google is another one I'm keeping my eyes on, guys. Again, this is one that I'm currently in. We saw the big sell-off, the margin of profit opened up, right? We sold off today again, but it seems like we pushed to another higher high with a very slight green day today of about $4, up 0.3%. This is looking pretty solid, guys, and I do plan on adding more money at about $1,200 if we do end up getting there, if the markets do end up recovering. So Microsoft, ticker symbol MSFT, this is one that sold off, recovered, but what I want to note, what I want to point you guys out towards is the potential descending pattern that we're seeing here of lower highs, right? The lower high at 128.50, 129.30, and 130.123. Ideally, I would like to see a break above 129.30 before entering a position into Microsoft to capitalize up to the previous high at about $131.23. So Microsoft, pretty solid there. Square is actually one that recovered very nicely today, although the pattern isn't looking too ideal here. I would like to see a break out of the 50 SMA resistance before even touching this one, but I figured I'd open it up here and show you. It recovered from $65 all the way up to $70. That's nearly a 7% move. Absolutely crazy in terms of Square stock. And what other ones here, guys? You know, we have UWT. That's one I day traded today. Again, you know, this one, in terms of UWT and crude oil right now, we are seeing, on crude oil especially, we're seeing a bit of a resistance here on the 20-day, one-hour chart, under the 180 simple moving average here. If we do break out of that tomorrow, that's going to be a breakout move on crude oil. At that point, I'm going to be trading UWT. So those are honestly just a couple that I'm watching, guys. If honestly, I'm just being very cautious tomorrow again. You know, this selling off could continue for this whole week. Who knows, guys? But I want to be cautious with a bunch of cash on the sidelines waiting for buying opportunities. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. Feel free to subscribe to the channel if you're new and you enjoy the content, and drop a comment down below. Let me know what you think about the current market. And if you haven't already, join our Strive Smart Discord group chat as well as our Strive Smart Facebook group. Both of those are linked down below in the description box, and they're 100% free of charge. So I hope you guys did great today. I hope you all have a great rest of your night. Good luck tomorrow. Shoot me a DM on any platforms if you have any questions. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.